Hello students, welcome to the e-learning platform presented by Mechanical Engineering Department of Dr. Bapuji Saloke Institute of Engineering and Technology, Kolhapur.
Let us start with unit number 2, testing of IC engine and emission control. This unit consists of 16 marks. Different types of testing required for working of an IC engine will be studied in this chapter, and different devices used to control the emission coming out of the IC engine will be studied in this chapter. Numerical based on testing of IC engine are also asked during your examinations. The learning objective for today's session are: number 1, study of types of IC engine. The necessity of IC engine testing and different types of IC engine testing will be studied in today's session. And second, study of different power developed by the engine. There are 3 types of various power developed by an IC engine, which we are going to study in today's session. Starting on engine testing. What is the basic need to test an engine? Why engine testing is necessary? There are number of reasons for which the engine testing is necessary. One of the is to record the analysis of to record the performance of the engine. The necessity of testing an internal combustion engine are: number 1, to obtain information about the engine which cannot be determined by calculation. Whenever a design engineer designs an engine, there are certain values which cannot be calculated by the calculation. So to analyze the performance of the engine or how it is working, we need the engine testings. Second, to confirm the data used in design. While designing of an engine, we assume certain data or we take arbitrarily some data which is not in the books or which is not according to the theory, but we have to assume it for the proper working of the engine. This data gets confirmed after the engine is properly running or after the engine is tested. It also validates the doubt which are there, if any. And third, to satisfy the customer as to rated power output with guaranteed fuel consumption. The rated power output given for an engine is guaranteed, and the fuel consumption is also guaranteed after the engine testing. So engine testing is a very important point nowadays. The engine testing is carried out are usually performed in 2 types of test. Number 1 is the commercial testing. Commercial testing, the test on internal combustion engine is carried out for commercial purpose to check the rated power of engine with respect to the fuel consumption in kg per kilowatt hour. That is the power developed with respect to the fuel consumed. Is to get this quantity, we test the engine in commercial testing. The quantity of lubricating oil required on brake power basis per kilowatt hour. That is the lubricating oil required for the engine developing the power per kilowatt. The third is the quantity of cooling water required on brake power basis in kg per kilowatt hour. The steadiness of the engine when loaded at different loads, overload carrying capacity of engine, and accuracy of the timing of valves. These are the following purposes for which commercial testing of an engine is done. The main purpose is to calculate the power output the quantity of lubricating oil required, the quantity of cooling water required, the steadiness of the engine, the load overload carrying capacity of engine, and the accurate timing of the valves. This is important as per the commercial purpose of the engine. The second type is the thermodynamic testing. Thermodynamic test is different from commercial test. They are carried out for comparing the actual result with the theoretical or ideal performances. While conducting such test, it is necessary to measure losses in addition to useful part of the energy and also draw up heat balance account. After conducting such tests, the performance of engine is compared with historical record and is used for improvement and development of IC engine. The measurement is necessary to determine the various mechanical and thermal efficiencies of the engine and to draw up the heat balance account. The different powers that are measured during the thermodynamic testing are the indicated power, the brake power, Mohr's test for calculating the mechanical efficiency in the case of multi-cylinder high-speed engine, rate of fuel consumption and its calorific value, flow rate of cooling water and rise of temperature for cooling, for calculating the heat carried away by cooling water and heat carried away by exhaust gases. The thermodynamic test will be studied in detail in coming further session. In this further session, we are going to see the how indicated power and brake power are calculated. Starting with engine power. Number one is indicated power. As by the name itself, the power developed inside the cylinder of an IC engine is known as indicated power and is usually denoted by IP. IP. Indicated power of an engine at particular speed can be calculated with the help of indicator that is fitted to the engine cylinder. The strength of the spring is used to be used in indicator must be chosen carefully. The indicator power usually is produced inside the engine cylinder by burning of fuel and is known as indicated power of an engine. The indicated power is also known as work done per cycle into speed of engine. It is calculated by finding out the mean effective pressure, that is PM. Indicated power can also be calculated or is calculated by using the formula below. Indicated power PIP is equal to PM into A into L into N, where the PM stands for mean effective pressure, A stands for the area, L stands for length of stroke, and N stands for, N is the speed of engine. For two stroke engine, the IP is equal to PM into A into L into N. Whereas for four stroke engine, indicated power is calculated as PM into A into L into N by 2. Here N by 2 is taken because one power stroke is completed into 2 revolution of crankshaft. Indicated power can also be calculated with the help of the spring gauge connected to the cylinder. Next type of power is brake power. As the name implies, the brake power It is the power available at engine crankshaft for doing the useful work. It is also known as engine power output. The brake power is less than compared to the indicator power due to the following losses. One is pumping losses due to suction and exhaust. Mechanical losses in bearing, resistance of air to flywheel rotation, and power required to drive the other auxiliaries connected to the engine, that is fuel pump, governor, lubricating oil pump, etc. Brake power is measured by the use of mechanical, electrical, hydraulic, or air brake dynamometer. It is measured by dynamometer. Brake power is given by BP is equal to 2 pi NT upon 60. Brake power is also known by the word BP, and it is given by 2 pi NT upon 60, where N is equal to speed RPM of the engine, whereas T is equal to torque of the engine. After studying the indicated power and the brake power, the last power that is developed, or that is between the two, is friction power. Friction power is nothing but the difference between the indicated power and the brake power. When the engine develops a certain amount of power, the whole power is not converted into useful amount of work. Some are lost in pumping or are used for other auxiliaries of IC engine. And this, the power that is lost for pumping and for other auxiliaries, is known as friction power. Friction power is given by FP, and it is equal to IP minus BP, that is indicated power minus brake power. Friction power can be calculated by various methods, which we are going to learn in further coming sessions. The friction power is merely important as it decides the efficiency of an engine. If the friction losses are less, then the friction power developed will also be less. Thus, the mechanical efficiency of an engine will increase. That is, the amount of power developed will be equal to amount of power used. That is, whenever the indicated power and brake power will equal, the mechanical efficiency will be 100%. So for today's session, we have completed the different types of engine testing, commercial testing, and thermodynamic testing, and power developed by the engine, that is indicated power, brake power, and friction power. The different types of tests to measure the friction power will be studied in the further section, or the different types of measuring equipments for the friction power will be studied in the further session. Thank you.